Welcome back to your free training course for Windows 7, our free gift to you. If you already have a computer running Windows, you may want to upgrade to Windows 7. Upgrading allows you to keep all your existing settings and saves you from having to reinstall your applications. If you perform a clean install of Windows 7, you will need to reinstall your applications and copy over your settings. This is called a migration. This is more time-consuming than simply upgrading. When you purchase an upgrade license, you purchase the right to upgrade your operating system. This can be done either by a clean install or upgrading an existing install. When you perform a clean install, setup will ask for your previous key to ensure that you are entitled to an upgrade. If you want to perform an upgrade, you need to meet a few prerequisites. First, you must be running Windows Vista with Service Pack 1 or Service Pack 2. If you are running Windows XP, there is no upgrade path to Windows 7. You will need to perform a migration, or a workaround is to upgrade to Windows Vista first and then upgrade to Windows 7. Also, when upgrading, you must upgrade to the same architecture. A 32-bit version of Windows Vista can only be upgraded to a 32-bit version of Windows 7. Also, a 64-bit version of Windows Vista can only be upgraded to a 64-bit version of Windows 7. Before you start the upgrade process, you should check that your hardware and software are compatible with Windows 7. It is a good idea to check with the manufacturer of each device and software product. They may have released updates for Windows 7. You can also run the upgrade advisor supplied by Microsoft. This will identify any known software or hardware problems with the upgrade to Windows 7. When upgrading to Windows 7 from Windows Vista, you must upgrade to an equivalent edition or a greater edition. The following upgrades are supported. Most of the editions of Windows 7 have an edition with the same name. The exception to this is the Windows Vista Business Edition. The best match to this on Windows 7 is the Professional Edition. You will notice that some literature suggests that you can, for example, upgrade from Windows Vista Premium to Windows 7 Professional, but in this table you will see that you cannot. Once you are running Windows 7, you are free to upgrade to any edition of Windows 7 as long as it has more features. So I would suggest that if you purchase an upgrade, read very carefully about what editions you can upgrade to. Maybe the upgrade allows you to upgrade to a certain edition of Windows 7, but does not support an in-place upgrade. This essentially means you would have to perform a clean install. Read carefully what you can upgrade and upgrade to, and if it supports an in-place upgrade. However, as I stated earlier, once you are running Windows 7, you are free to upgrade to any edition of Windows 7 as long as it has more features. Later in the video, I will have a look at how to do that, but first, let's look at how to upgrade a Windows Vista system to Windows 7. Before starting the upgrade, I'm going to go to the Microsoft website and download the Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor. The advisor is simple to install and can be installed on Windows XP, Windows Vista, and Windows 7, both on the 32-bit and 64-bit versions. Simply run the setup program and accept all the prompts. Later on, I will look at upgrading between different editions of Windows 7. If you are planning to do this, the Upgrade Advisor can be run on a Windows 7 computer as well. Once installed, I can run the Upgrade Advisor from the Start menu. Note on the welcome screen the message, "Connect and turn on all your devices." If you have any USB devices such as printers, scanners, etc., you should connect these up so that the advisor can see if there are any potential problems. Remember that when you use the Upgrade Advisor, it can only alert you to problems it knows about. Still, this is better than nothing. Once I press the button Start Check, the Upgrade Advisor will start checking my system for problems. The process does take a few minutes, so I will skip forward to the end. At the top, you can see the Upgrade Advisor will tell you to which editions of Windows 7 you can upgrade. It also gives you a link giving you more information about those editions. Notice also the upgrade advisor has highlighted there is only 1 GB of RAM in the computer. For best performance with 64-bit, you should have 2 GB. This is not a showstopper in this case, as you can run Windows 7 with 1 GB of RAM. However, you should take note of the recommendation, as upgrading a poorly spec'd system may result in having a very sluggish computer after the upgrade. Notice the next warning is telling me I need more free disk space. Before I attempt an upgrade, I'm going to have to free up some space or install a bigger hard disk. The next message is an information message telling me that some features in Windows Vista are not available in Windows 7. There are other products available from Microsoft to replace these. For example, you can download Windows Live Mail to replace Microsoft Mail, which is no longer included in Windows 7. The next section shows devices and whether they are compatible or not. These devices I know work with Windows 7. If I have a device that appears in here, I should check with the manufacturer of that device to ensure they have a driver for Windows 7. Down at the bottom of the screen, you can see a list of programs that the upgrade advisor has checked. Now that the system has been checked, I can insert the Windows DVD into the system to upgrade Windows Vista to Windows 7. Don't worry about the warning about limited hard disk space. I paused the video and freed up some while you weren't looking. Remember that when upgrading, you must run the setup from the operating system from which you are upgrading. You cannot boot from the DVD. If I insert the DVD, launch the setup, and then start the upgrade, all I need to do is select Install Now. Once the setup starts, you will notice that there is a different screen not included when booting from the DVD, thumb drive, or running the setup from the network. The upgrade will allow you to download updates from Microsoft before starting the upgrade. I would recommend selecting the option Go Online to get the latest upgrades for installation. If you have a buggy driver, it may cause your upgrade to fail. Before your first successful login to Windows 7, you have the option to roll back to Windows Vista, but it is best to apply the updates first to maximize the success of your upgrade. Next, I will need to accept the license, and on the next screen, I can select the option Upgrade. Since I ran setup from the operating system that I want to upgrade, this option will work. On the next screen, Windows will check the system for compatibility problems. You can see that I get a message telling me that Ultimate Extras has been discontinued in Windows 7. Once I press Next, Windows will start the upgrade process. This does take a long time to complete, so I will pause the video. Once Windows has finished copying over the install files, programs, and settings, it will reboot and ask you for a license key. I like to deselect the option Automatically Activate Windows when I'm online. If this option is ticked, Windows will attempt to automatically activate itself with Microsoft in 3 days. Otherwise, you need to perform this step manually. However, you have 30 days to perform this step. If something goes wrong in the 30 days, you can perform a reinstall without penalty. On the next screen, you can decide how automatic updates will be installed. In this case, I will select the recommended settings. On the next screen, you need to set the date, time, and time zone. For security in Windows 7 to work correctly, particularly if you're going to put Windows 7 into a domain, these settings need to be set correctly. Finally, I get to decide which firewall profile should be used for my network card. This computer will be put into a domain, so I will select the option Work. Once selected, Windows will finalize its settings before you are presented with a login screen. If you are happy with the upgrade, log in. If you think something went wrong, you have the option to roll back the upgrade. Just remember, once you log into Windows 7 for the first time, you will not be able to roll back the upgrade. Using the Windows 7 In Place upgrade allows you to upgrade to Windows 7 from Windows Vista. However, you may not be able to upgrade directly to the edition of Windows 7 that you want. Windows 7 has the ability to upgrade from one edition to another as long as the edition you are upgrading to has more features. Looking at this table, you can see that once you are running Windows 7, you can upgrade to any edition with more features. Having said that, you will notice that you cannot upgrade to the Enterprise Edition. The Enterprise and Ultimate Editions have the same feature set. What is different is the way they are licensed. Using Anytime Upgrade will allow you to upgrade to an edition of Windows 7 to which you cannot upgrade directly. For example, you could upgrade from Windows Vista Home Premium to Windows 7 Professional by first upgrading to Windows 7 Home Premium and then performing an Anytime upgrade to Windows 7 Professional. This, of course, does mean that you have to purchase two upgrades, one from Windows Vista to Windows 7 and another from Windows 7 Premium to Windows 7 Professional. Remember, however, when upgrading between different editions of Windows 7, you cannot change the architecture of the operating system. In other words, using Anytime Upgrade does not provide an upgrade path from Windows 7 32-bit to Windows 7 64-bit. To perform that kind of upgrade, you need to perform a clean install and then copy over your settings. To demonstrate how to use the Windows Anytime Upgrade, I will now switch to a computer running Windows 7 Premium Edition. First of all, you need to run Windows Anytime Upgrade from the Start menu. From the first screen of the wizard, you get the option to enter in an upgrade key if you have one. If you do not have a key, you can select the option and go online to choose the edition of Windows 7 that's best for you. At the top of the screen, you can see that I am currently running Windows 7 Home Premium Edition. This gives me the option to upgrade to the Professional Edition or the Ultimate Edition using Windows Anytime Upgrade. If you want to know more about the edition you are upgrading to, you can select the tab at the top. These will give you more information about the Professional Edition and Ultimate Edition. When you are ready, press the Buy button and complete the payment wizard. I won't go through the upgrade process, however, it is a simple wizard and may only take 10 minutes to complete. This completes upgrading to Windows 7. In the next video, I will look at installing Windows 7 from the network, which is a good choice when you have a lot of Windows 7 installs to perform.